Hey, what's up, dude? So, this is a little embarrassing. The correct episode 4 has gone missing. I might have accidentally deleted it and then emptied a recycle bin. That is possibly completely me. And that's the embarrassing part. But the reason why I say gone missing is because I might have also changed the file name, deleted, then put in the recycle bin. And then after all of that, it's now when you try to look in the recovery to see if you can save the file, it turns out that I had no idea what the file name could have been. But it gets weirder because I filmed it in a batch of 3, and on that day, there's only a batch of 2 things that existed, apparently. I learned a lot about hard drives. Turns out that when you delete something in the recycle bin, it actually doesn't go away. It just says that this part of the hard drive is now okay to rewrite over. So keep that in mind when you want to like wipe a hard drive, is you don't actually wipe the hard drive. You just say, hey, it's free to rewrite over this stuff. So it'll say, hey, I have 8 terabytes free or something because it's a clean hard drive. But really, it has 8 terabytes of your data still there. Just they can be written over. Anyway, I figure the best way to do this is in a skill that I'm very proud of, which is basically I'm going to try to pantomime the episode to you relatively quickly, and then we're just going to move into the next episode because I don't know what the hell to do, and it's late, and I'm tired, and that seems like the best thing ever. So, we begin. We're sneaking. We're scared of the surrounding environment because we've just been in a firefight, and we're hiding inside that little Corvega, little walking way that is a safe spot where we were standing on top of earlier in this episode. We run through, sneaking around. We find the burnt corpses on the ground and we see them and we go, loot, 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 because hey, they're corpses. Once we get them, people start shooting at us, raiders from above. Ah, where are they coming from? Wait, there's a bubblehead in that direction. We can go get it. So we run, 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 and we get, and we shoot some more people and it gets quiet again and we're safe. We sneak up higher. Don't hear anybody. Sneak up a little higher. And we climb up the Corvega plant to get hired up to that bubblehead. And as we get up there, suddenly there are more raiders. And we shoot them. And as they get shot and they crash and they down, it's quiet again. We sneak around. We find the bubblehead. And I was all excited because I thought it was going to be something really cool. It's a repair bubblehead so that power, you know, fusion cores can last longer. Kind of nice in the case of, like, if our character needs to use a power armor and carries the fusion core with him, then it would decrease the amount of fusion core we lose, which is nice because in the future, maybe we would not have to get as many fusion cores because of that whole number fusion core thing. Anywho, a little disappointing, but that's okay because we hear more shooting. So we're running around, running around, look, shooting down below us. We shoot through the grates to try to get to the bad guys, but we can't. So we jump off and we land on a nearby grate and fire at the bad guy and take him out. Nice. However, we're in a problem. We have a sickness. And we need to figure out what to do with this sickness. So, we go, we look around, and we save at a bed nearby. Good. Works out. Then I go, you know what, let's try Corvega plant anyway, even with this little sickness. So we go, and we try to do the Corvega plant entrance. We open up those double doors where it says Corvega plant and go through the front, and there's that Jangles the Moon Monkey who's ready to alert everybody that you're there. Well, it didn't because somebody saw us instead, and it was a little disappointing. But we didn't explode in that one trip mine that's in the front of Corvega plant, so we were safe. So we run in, we see the guy, we shoot him, we take that guy out, he's right by the water fountain, and we kill that guy, and he falls, and we're like, yes! And then we go up, and Jingles the Moon Monkey's there, and we punch him in the face so that his head falls off, which was nice. Then a bunch of guys start coming out anyway, because, well, I mean, we already had, they'd heard gunshots, it had nothing to do with the monkey, but the monkey deserves it. There's a hallway when you enter Corvega plant, and we're hiding behind that front desk area, which is where the receptionist would have sat. And we're firing over the gun, but the thing is there's books and shit in the way, and we're knocking them over, and bullets are hitting them, and we're doing really bad, and I throw a Molotov and hit the wall. It doesn't hit the bad guys, it hits the wall, and they don't get burned. And then the fire is just there, and I'm shooting through fire, and they're shooting through fire, and I'm actually getting hurt a lot, so I run over to the drinking fountain and drink water as much as I could. But I didn't get enough. And I had a lot of radiation. And I was like, ah, oh, crap. A lot of radiation. Needed more health. Eventually, we kill the guys. We run around. We get into the center of the plant. And there's a lot of people. And I throw a Molotov. It causes a big panic. But it's a bit of a problem. And so we just go, ugh, and run away. Run back out. Go back outside. And I think, okay, And I say this to the camera like this. All right, dude, so we're going to finish up the rest of Corvega plant, but I'm going to make sure to get a save first. So we're going to start outside the place, but trust me, we're going to just go right on back in and it'll be fine. And then I did that. And then, well, this happened after. Hey, what's up, dudes? Kublai Khan here. Welcome back to Fallout 4 Survival Mode with our Child of Adam Ghoul build, who is super sick. Holy, look at this. Look at that. Look at all those. It's insane. And, yeah. It turns out that sleeping outside in a non-owned bed, even if it's a sweet-looking bed that's raised up, your character can pick up a lot of crazy diseases. Ugh, we got periodic damage. Suppressed immunity was caused because I thought I could take a rat away and sleep for 10 hours and not have to worry about it. Well, I don't know why I just saved. Or paused. Anyway, well, it turns out that doesn't quite work that way. So we need some antibiotics. And that would be super cool. I was planning to, and last you saw me, I was in Corvega plant. But we need something now to kind of fix what we've done to our character. I don't necessarily want to go trying to do Corvega plant when I'm randomly going to get injuries. Now, I happen to know there's a pharmacy here. Your infection spreads. Just took some more damage just for the sake of taking damage, because god damn it. So anyway, I happen to know that there's a pharmacy over in this direction. Hopefully I don't set off the guy with the nuke as I'm running through here, but I think it's going to be fine. Because I'm going pretty quick. We're jumping over cars like a freaking Super Rambo. We can also run into Corvega plant through that. What was that about me avoiding the nuke guy? Something along the lines of I'm going fast enough. Yeah, that was it. Going fast enough. Okay, here we go. Try two. We're gonna go from this time from the roof. Alright. Remember this process?
What the fuck was that?
I fell through all the things.
First mistake, last mistake.
Woo! And we missed the nuke explosion. Glad to hear that we've made it. Okay, on our way to that pharmacy. Perfect. It's up and to the right, if I recall correctly. Here? Nope. Board it off. You know, who boards off these doors? Here we go. Pharmacy. Oh, go inside! Did you hear the nuke in the background? Ooh, yeah, I heard the nuke in the background. Jesus. Okay, let's see if they have any antibiotics in here. Found some jet, some water, a cigarette carton. Not exactly the kind of human empathy, robotic precision, Milton General Hospital. Huh, Milton's. Very cool. Radex. Dude holding onto a thing of Radex for dear life. Damn, my infection's still spreading. Stim pack, a walking cane, which is the worst melee weapon in the game above the rolling pin. But hey, there it is. Fortunately, this pharmacy doesn't have anything, even though I still have freaking infection spreading. Okay, so I don't really need medical nitrogen sprayer. All right, we are currently hidden from the nuke guy who is shooting a nuke at us as we were escaping, which is, whew, all right, we made it out. So I'm thinking, because of how absolutely screwed we are in relation to, like, healing, let's just keep trying to head our way to, ooh, wait, I have an idea. Perhaps fire support, the group of guys for the Brotherhood of Steel mission, they might have some antibiotics, and they're like, too much weight. I mean, our character doesn't necessarily hate the Brotherhood or anything. There was discussion originally about the character and disliking the Brotherhood. Apparently we're just... Really? It's still... We're out of frequency range, but the game still gave us the option to do the Freedom Calls thing. The advantage, like I said, is it's possible they might... That's a car in here. Oh, it's foggy. Gotcha. There's an advantage for us that we might actually be... Oh, ghoulies! Hello! Mrs. Oh, Mr. Sumner. I do not appreciate your hospitality. I'm assuming this is Mrs. Sumner? Is that... Yep, this is Mrs. Sumner. Jesus. Hey, she has a kickball. Didn't realize she was a fan. Anywho, bottle cap. Oh, my infection is horrible. Still continuing to spread. Oh, come on. Somebody got to have some antibiotics on them. This particular infection is really tough. All right. Apparently somebody can see me. Mr. Parker has a baseball? Hmm. Oh, danger. Oh, hey. Mrs. Donahue. Go away. Oh, man. Yeah, we might need to go to the Brotherhood of Steel, guys, because they're going to provide us with some more weaponry. Jesus. The weaponry that they'll be providing us is... Nice, 10mm. Is, like, they'll be taking us to that one jet place where they have, like, the scrap, the junk jet and stuff like that. Biggest advantage with that will be we'll get also the sweetest rifle ever and a lot of microfusion cells. So we'll have a laser rifle, which will really help out with our particular situation. However, I'm not 100% sure what to do with our situation because the biggest problem is this... I hear explosion. Because the biggest problem is the fact that our antibiotics are so screwy. Or, you know, we're suffering from this infection. I totally see a rad scorpion there. Shit. How much damage can I do to it? Nothing. That is nothing. Okay. This is problematic. How do we do this? Alright, so I'm debating on going straight to Diamond City to the best that we can because... Ooh, we're actually still pretty far from it. The thought process I have with going to Diamond City... is that if we're able to get there... There's a doctor. You know, we can restock up on some things. We have a lot of different ammos and... Fine. Fuck. Fuck, 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 fuck. Climb, climb up. Yep. First person. Ah, okay. That's scary. Can it take stairs? These are very small stairs. Doesn't seem to be able to take the stairs very easily. Well, a protectron. A green protectron. That's going to be helpful. Huh.
Initiating search for
that's also a college right there. So perhaps that would be worthwhile going. Somebody was here. Okay, I'm not exactly excited about, you know, wow, they had psycho and stuff. I'm not. Why does? All right, well, we're gonna get a drop a save at least, so that's gonna be helpful. But ooh, what is this? Hardened sniper rifle. It's not. It's probably not gonna be worth carrying. A little too heavy, especially for what our character likes to use. So, well, at least the Rad Scorpion's being taken. We've dropped a save, which is helpful, too. You know what? Let's help out. Yeah, there we go. We can get some experience from this. Nice. I also happen to know that Rad Meat isn't the meat. Or is a Rad Scorpion egg omelet? You can actually get some pretty nice stuff. Ooh, weapons workbench. Ooh, this is kind of nice. Here, I'm going to jump for a second. Ah, infection. Just realize a long hardened 10mm pistol is actually kind of sexily named. Said it long and hard, and I was like, wow, I'm surprised I never noticed that before. Sharp red baseball bat, we don't really use it much, but hey, it could help. Okay, it's a beautiful sunny day. We have upgraded our weapons a little bit. I now have two aptly named things. Gun nut yet, but I've made, if I have to, that's basically a pipe pistol that we've knocked up into generally almost the same range as this guy, which is the ooh baby. So if I have to is the joke I have is where it's like, if I have to use this lame gun versus the ooh baby, I cannot wait to use it. Increased a little bit on their general hip fire accuracy as well as general comfort. Damn, my infection is problematic. Okay, we will die from our disease if we're not able to find a way to keep ourselves alive. Luckily, I'm gonna be able to pop a Nuka-Cola to kind of just keep our health up, fight off some of the, you know, that disease that I'm worried about. Properly hydrated again though, so that's good. Like I said, if I'm guessing potentially, we're so close. Okay, we're gonna have to fight a lot of ghouls here, but we're very close. And if we're able to get this to work, we might be able to find some antibiotics that'll work pretty well. Here's some stuff up here. Hold on, is there... No, these guys don't have a first aid kit. That's very dangerous. Not that it would have helped in this post-apocalyptic world, that the bombs fell on top of, but it would have helped me, so... Darg. Alright, we're very close. The ghouls are gonna be very tough. I don't really think I could get away with using, the oh, fine one, really. I might be able to do that with some... Oh, fragmentation grenades. Not Molotovs. Alright, here we go. Help out! Help him out! Get involved! Get involved! Okay, we're involved. Throw a grenade over there. Alright, well, I blew up some corpses. Oh, I shot the wrong guy! Sorry! Alright, I got this window. You guys got that one. Alright, well, there's a lot of them coming through here, so we'll just shoot this way. Alright. Up! Car's exploding. Up! Fair ghouls. Oh god, I thought it killed this person. Whew. Hoo-wee! Hey, you know what, Dance? I'll talk to you in a sec. Oh, my infection. We'll talk to you in a second. I just want to go pick some corpses, okay? You know, I've never actually fought any of these guys from up here before. Oh, antibiotics. Come on. Oh, damn it. All right, well, a lot of ammunition is stored up top. And we got a brother... A laser rifle, and the fatigues might be really cool. Well, we can at least take, I would take the laser rifle, but we don't need this particular laser rifle because this one is in fact not gonna be as good as the one we're going to be getting. And I'm not gonna be trying to fight, you know, too close to what Paladin Dance is doing. I think I'm gonna leave a lot of the battles that are up and coming to him. So that'll just have to work. Stimpak, god damn it. Alright, well, you guys do your thing. I'm gonna talk to Paladin now.
Excuse me.
We appreciate the assistance, civilian, but what's your business here?
I'm trying to survive is one of the most accurate comments that you can do here. It's true. Ah, my infection is spreading mid-conversation. It's difficult to
believe. Are you from a local settlement?
You know, we're actually from Sanctuary. That should
I'm
work.
I'm from Sanctuary Hills, on the other side of
For our character
I've
roleplay
seen the location
wise.
On our maps, but I've never visited the area myself. There isn't much over there for us to collect. If
yeah,
I appear suspicious, it's because our mission here has been difficult. Since the moment we arrived in the Commonwealth, we've been constantly under fire. If you want to continue pitching in, we could use an extra gun on our side.
Yeah, let's I'll do it.
I'll continue to help, but you owe me an explanation first.
Very well. I'm Paladin Dance, Brotherhood of Steel. Over there is Scribe Halen and Knight Reese. We're on recon duty, but I'm down a man and our supplies are running low. I've been trying to send a distress call to my superiors. But the signal's too weak to reach them.
Sir, if I may...
Proceed, Halen.
I've modified the radio tower on the roof of the police station. But I'm afraid it just isn't enough. What we need is something that will boost the signal.
Our target is ArcJet Systems, and it contains the technology we need. The deep-range transmitter. We infiltrate the facility, secure the transmitter, and bring it back here. So what do you say? You willing to lend the Brotherhood of Steel a hand?
We're gonna go yes...
Let's get moving.
Because outstanding.
Hopefully, like, not only will that rifle be really useful.
We'd need the key.
Wait.
Halen, take Reese inside and bind his wounds.
Can I go inside?
Reese, once you're on your feet, I want you to make certain the perimeter is secure.
All right. The infection's still spreading, dudes.
It's time to prove your worth. Head into the police station and resupply yourself.
Don't have the key.
Then let me know when you're ready to begin.
Thank God. Please have antibiotics in there.
Let's go.
God. Hey, level up. That's pretty cool. Alright, so we got a sweet level up to help us along. Hopefully they have some antibiotics here. Inactive distress pulser, 10mm rounds, fusion cells, taken all of that. I'll speak up if I see anything that's particularly useful to bring up. They've got this pipe revolver pistol, which could be pretty sick. I'm carrying too much to run though, so I'm gonna have to drop some stuff. So it turns out the Brotherhood fatigues are actually better than all our leather armor put on us. So that's an easy decision to make there. Let's get a good look at it, though. That looks pretty cool. Ah, god, that infection is brutal. Alright, so I see no reason why we shouldn't just pop up Gunslinger. Because although, something like armor would be really cool to, you know, or not even armor, gun nut, excuse me. God, gun nut would be really sick to pop up our gun, you know, our abilities to make more stuff. But we clearly need something like Gunslinger to just, because we don't have necessarily any workbench nearby. There is, in fact, in this police report, a certain officer, Winter's End. You can go ahead and take that. I think it's related to the Nick thing, which is pretty cool. Wow, there's a lot of drugs in here. I believe it's related to Nick. Oh, man, we do not have any A lot of stim packs, which are cool. And a lot of useful things. A lot of cool stuff in here, but it looks like I'm going to actually have to leave a pile of just things here that I'm... Ooh, shotgun shells too? Wow. Yeah. Ow, God, I know I'm over-encumbered, but... Okay, well, it looks like we're going to use this box here as an opportunity just to store some stuff because I'm carrying too many things, and it's become a bit of a problem. And if we're carrying too much stuff, well, I'm going to keep getting hurt. I'm not going to be able to find anything new. I feel comfortable dropping a lot of junk, I think. Actually, you know what? I don't really need to worry about money now that I'm thinking about it. In the case of, I mean, for example, let's put these things away. I'm going to use one of these pistols, so I'm cool with that. But the reason why I feel more comfortable putting away some of these items is, let's put it in a very basic point of view. What use are they going to be if, let's see. All right, we already actually, ooh, that's a different version of that. What use are they going to be compared to, like, ammunition, which is the best weight to value ratio? God, I love hitting that light. I think it's hilarious. Okay, so we can unlock this for a quick experience boost. Anyway, so yeah, this location actually is located to Nick Valentine's particular personal quest. All right, we got some pretty cool stuff here. Ooh, what's... Ooh, nice. Wonder glue back there too. Damn, we got some great stuff here. Problem still that we're running into. This infection, no antibiotics. Maybe ArcJet will have antibiotics. I don't know. I mean, finding our way towards Diamond City, I think would also provide a good opportunity to really get some antibiotics. Or even just a general, you know what? I have an idea that I didn't think about. What if we just went back to the diner, the Drumlin Diner? I mean, here, checking the map. Drumlin Diner is right here. We're pretty close to that. You know, we can put a marker on it. We can make a travel back. This will be the first time we've ever done a travel like this before. So I'm very curious to see what it's going to be like. Because normally we would just like fast travel, right? I've never come out through this garage direction. There's a ton of cool stuff in here. Economy Wonder Glue, Cap Stash. This is nice. I'm excited to see this. Used oil cans. I'm really used to grabbing oil. Although, honestly, this character doesn't really use oil. So I should probably stop doing that. Gears, maybe, because of various guns that we pick up. But, yeah, I've never actually gone through the garage area of this part. Oh, that's pretty sick. I should keep this in mind as a potential in and out that could be a safe spot. Alright, so what we're gonna do... Oh, God, that infection. Oh, shoot. Okay, hold on. I forgot to drop a save inside this location. Let's quickly drop a save inside the location. Then we're going to go run over to the Drumlin Diner. Let's see how that feels, that kind of amount of time it takes.
Why are you standing around here like there's nothing to do?
The guy gets so angry about us not doing the Paladin Dance stuff. I mean, I can respect the fact that in his point of view, I am just some stupid jerk who's not doing anything. You know, like, I just show up, take all their ammunition, I'm clearly just looking around for stuff to make, like, to put in my pockets. And, you know, and then I'm here, and I'm like, yeah, I'm here to help. But they're like, are you really here to help? I don't really know if I agree with you on that. And it's like, yep, I'm here to help. And it's just like, as I'm trying to find antibiotics and just work with them purely for my own advantage. Plus, I'm now wearing one of their guys' armors. Like, his clothing itself. Like that's insane. You know, that kind of sucks, and I could be very disappointed if I saw someone doing that with my buddy's clothing, too. Okay, I just popped the stim pack as I needed it. Feeling better but still parched. One more water is all I need. That's a psycho! Shit! Well, now we just popped a psycho. For no reason. Oh, damn. You know, I've never actually walked this road before. There's stuff smoking over there. Hold on, what is that? I'm kind of curious. Hey, I've never actually walked this... Your infection spreads. I've never actually walked this road... Oh! Child of Adam are actually here. Yeah, I've been here before, and there's Child of Adam here. Long brown rags. Awesome. Oh, this was a woman? I couldn't tell because she was bald and upside down. Huh, there you go. That was a little bit of a backward sexist thought of mine, being assuming that a woman could not be bald. What a terrible person. So it has, wow, it has good endurance too. We're not gonna wear that in replace of what we're currently doing, but hey, check it. Our character is ready to go into the Crater of Adam and the like. We're now dressed correctly for it. So I'm happy about that. Got what we need. Now let's be prepared for, is that a brick? That's a brick. More of these guys. Oh, I'm carrying too much to run. Yeesh. Okay, let's see if we can find some antibiotics here. Just so you guys know, as you're running through, there's a bunch of traps in this location. I'm gonna try to call them out before I run into them. There's also these little stupid dudes, which is why I pulled out my bat, because I love batting the mole rats. It's so much fun. We'd get the meat from them, but right now we just don't have any space. Things look oddly green differently than I'm used to. Oh, I missed that one. You know what? We're gonna bat like this. You're not dead yet, so you get one hit. I'm Oprah of baseball. You get one hit. Following, you get two hits. There you go. God, I love they're getting knocked back. So our bat right now causes extra bleeding damage. So anybody we hit, oh, that's a corpse. So anybody we hit can in fact continue to get hurt after the strike. Okay, so we can do this. We're gonna do some mole rat cleanup in a second, get some more food. Once again though, antibiotics is our first thing that we want. I do believe that there is in fact a lot of radiation in this place, but because of who our character is, we don't actually experience it. Kind of an interesting, once again, something that I thought was kind of surprising about how our character worked. Oh, antibiotics. What a wonderful thing to find. Now, before we take them, we're going to take a sleep and drop a save. Now, the biggest reason that's important is because could you imagine sleeping there again and getting another infection right after using the antibiotics? But we don't have to worry about that because, boom, there we go. Oh, good. Feeling better, but still parched. Properly hydrated. Oh, this worked out perfectly. All right, I'm gonna go pick up some food now. Ooh, quantums and nuka cherries. Ooh, and an armor workbench. Interesting. Brotherhood fatigues you cannot alter. I have no armor I can modify. And there's a bottle cap mine. Heads up on that. So our character has a certain amount of armor based upon the Brotherhood fatigues. These two arms right here are 7. Alone, our character currently has 10 damage resistance wearing the fatigues. So really, our character is actually pretty much almost as strong with just those two pieces. So I think we're going to drop the fatigues pretty soon. I want to wear the military fatigues because you get 2 agility and 5 energy resistance versus army gives you a strength, which is good for carrying stuff. But I think this is actually going to be the better thing for our character. As I mentioned, grenades earlier, here's one of the grenades. We have a cluster, a grenade bouquet, and then you have a tripwire right there. So go ahead and grab yourself a grenade and get rid of that tripwire. And that's pretty cool. It's a nice thing to have. Okay, so we've actually cleaned this place out and gotten a lot of good stuff from here. Nukas and various grenades even. And then, so like our character is currently actually has less damage resistance than I did wearing the fatigues. But these arms are very, very good. So it's there immediately the moment I find some other armor, which we're gonna head back to the Cambridge Police Station, which is where we stored our other armor. We'll be able to pick that up and get a lot of benefits quickly. As you can see, I've decided to actually continue on to the store. I wanna sell pretty much a lot of the ammunition that we're not using. I wanna get that into caps. It's taking weight. And we're carrying things that we don't necessarily need either. So I'm A-okay with making a move in back to this direction. I mean, also check this out. We are relatively close to it. And then once we do that, we're also pretty close to Concord, which I could do a quick jump over and be able to get myself pretty, you know, a big boost of experience, perhaps another level up to give our character a little bit more. Now, I'm being careful right here because I was watching someone else's playthrough and, oh, feral ghouls, we're gonna shoot those. I was watching somebody else's playthrough and there were super mutants in there. So, oh, they're coming out of this door, are they? All right, walk around, okay. That works. Yeah, we could probably, whoa! Ow, God. I was thinking we could probably switch to this pistol for right now. I'm definitely going to be selling a lot of ammunition from this because we're just not using it and it's just taking weight. So, ooh, another potential save. And squirrel bits? What's an explorer outfit? Shitty. It's a shitty thing. That's what that is. Huh, okay. Well, bottle cap. Once again, too much to run. Gray knit cap for one. That's kind of cool. But we don't really need these things. I guess we can also take a quick, drop a quick save here. But we saved really recently and we're almost to where we're going to go. So I'm not going to do that. Okay, the indicator on our compass is going down. We are clearly within sight. But we need, ooh, check this out. Unfortunately, too much to run, but that was totally worth it. I love the fact that they have a porta diner up here. God, I love these things. Ah, one day we're going to see it work and it's going to be amazing. So another thing that is important about, wow, these guys are just still hanging out here? I thought they,
thanks for helping us out with Trudy. You did good. Now,
they might have antibiotics, business. Which is, that would be useful to buy.
Now remember, moderation.
Antibiotic moderation. Don't take too many. Okay, so I'm going to go searching through here to see if they have anything that we need. Dudes, we've made it to this point. Oh, this is very good. I'm going to be able to come back here. I'm going to do a couple things because we have 3 fusion cores that I'm able to now put away. And that's actually enough weight that that's going to be nice to put those away and not have to worry about it. So anyway, we're 3 fusion cores on the way to succeeding our goal. We already got the Brotherhood Rags. Things are going pretty well, so thank you so much for watching. It's a total joy to have you here. If you liked what you saw, please leave a like. If you want to see more, hit the subscribe button underneath me. And of course, may the ground rise to meet your feet, the wind always be at your back, and may the sun shine warmly on your sexy, sexy face. Dude, see you later. Bye.